Yeah, so over here, we are started with the new topic that is adaptations. It is topic 4.3 from page number 78 in your notebooks. All right, in your books, you have it on page number 78. All right, so yeah, when we talk about adaptations, first of all, we need to know the meaning of this term, right? Now, over here it is written the basic definition of adaptations, that is the process which enables organisms to adjust to their environment in order to ensure survival, right? This becomes your definition of an adaptations. Now, I know that this definition might sounds a bit tricky to you all, but over here just focus on to the point that all the animals which lives here and there or in their habitats, they have different characteristics or they have different traits, right? The characteristics that they have and those characteristics which enables the animals to live and to survive in our environment is known as the adaptations. All right, the characteristics or the traits that enables a living thing to live in a certain environment is known as the adaptations. Now over here as well, if you can see, they have given you another definition of adaptations, and it is the process or the state of adjusting or changing to become more suited to an environment. The trait is a result of the process. All right. Now, what is meant by trait? It is the characteristics. Now, over here, let me give you the example of ourselves that are humans, right? Since we are human beings and we live in our homes, right? Our homes becomes our habitat. Open air becomes our habitat. Now, in order to live in this environment, we have some characteristics into it, us. For example, we have our lungs and our nostrils, and it shows that it is compulsory for us to live and in an open air, right? We do not have wings. We do not have pedals, right? We do not have fins. So it means that we cannot survive into water. We can swim up to an extent, but we cannot survive in a water. Why? Because our bodies are not made like that. हमारी bodies इस तरह से नहीं बनी हुई है कि हम पानी में survive कर सकें. Even we cannot walk in the water for a very long time. You must have noticed that whenever you go for picnics into the swimming pool or near to the seaside, when you come back, your body becomes very weak. Why does your body feels weak? Because you swims there, you walk into the water there, and hence your body becomes weak. It becomes weak because your body is not designed to be survive into a water. You can live in a water for a few hours, you can enjoy there, but you cannot live over there for the rest of your life because our bodies are not meant like that, right? So adaptations are the characteristics of any living thing that is shaped or designed to live into the specific environment, right? Now, when we talk about adaptations, there are different animals who has different characteristics in order to survive into the I must say into the environment where they are living. Acha. Now over here, let us take the example of an owl, right? They are showing us I think almost 3 to 4 characteristics that has been designed according to it. Number one, they are talking about the wings of an owl, right? Totally silent flight from fringed flight feathers that muffle the sound of air passing through their feathers. Now, what are they telling us about the owls? They are telling us that their feathers are designed in such a way that air passes through it without making any noise or without making any sound. Although you can see that the furs or the feathers of, not furs, sorry, but the feathers of these owls are very scrambled. Still, the air that goes into it does not make any sound. कोई आवाज नहीं आती और वो आवाज क्यों नहीं आती है? So that it can move freely into the air and it can catches its prey. This is the reason, right? Now, large eyes set forward on the head gives great depth perception for hunting. Plus, retinas for their eyes are packed with low light sensitive rods to see at night. Now, their eyes are packed inside their face properly. Why? So that they can see their prey very zoomed light, right? And it also has a characteristic in its eyes that it can see very clearly even in the night time without any light. ठीक है ना? ये रात में भी आराम से देख सकते हैं. So that it becomes easier for them to survive and to catch their prey. Their necks have a lot of flexibility for following prey as they move. Sharp talons for catching prey on the fly. इसके पंजे भी बहुत sharp होते हैं. इसकी neck भी चारों तरफ घूम सकती है. So that it can see all its prey all around. Now these becomes the characteristics of an owl. So that it can enjoy in an open air and it can catch its prey as well. Now similarly, they are showing us different characteristics related to this polar bear. Now most bears eat some plants matter, but where polar bear lives, they have adapted to a totally carnivorous styles. Muscle hump over shoulders for catching large prey. White fur helps them hide in plain sight. Large furry feet for walking on ice and snow, right? So these are the four characteristics of a polar bear. Now they are saying that when we talk about bears, bears mostly depends upon plants. These other plants khate hain. But when we talk about polar bears specifically, they cannot survive. They cannot eat plants. Why? Because they live in an Antarctic Ocean where there is always freezing cold. There is only ice. So of course, there is no plant. So this becomes, because of it, they become carnivores. Yani ki ye animals khate hain, polar bears, right? Now they have those white fur so that they can hide in the snow as well. Theek hai, they have large fur on their body. Their bodies are totally covered with furs to keep their bloodstream warm and they don't die. Their feet are also very large. Their paws are very large so that it enables them to walk onto the ice without slipping. Last but not the least, there are few animals that lives inside the water. Now those animals are known as aquatic animals. Why are they known as aquatic animals? Because aqua means water, right? Animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. Most aquatic animals breathe through gills except whales and dolphins, which breathe through lungs. Most aquatic animals have fins or paddles that help them to swim. For example, fish, octopus, turtle, and crabs. Now there are so many species that lives in the water and those species are known as aquatic animals, right? Now those animals have their gills, theek hai, through which they breathe. Theek hai na, side par hote hai unke gills. But gills kin kin animals mein nahi hote? Whales or dolphins ke alawa sare jitne bhi animals hote hain sab mein gills hote hain. But only whales and dolphins are the animals that breathe through their lungs. They have their lungs only, right? And most aquatic animals have fins. Now, what are fins? Fins are the top coverings of their skin and paddles that help them to swim. And inke paddles bhi hote hain, yani ki inke paon bhi hote hain taki wo swim kar sake. Now, paddles ki example aapko duck se milegi. Duck ke jo feet hote hain na, unko paddles kehte hain, right? So that they can swim in the water and they can walk also. So that becomes the paddles. And these are all the different traits of different types of animals so that they can survive in different types of environment.